It's day 19. Hey you guys, and welcome back to my channel, and happy day 19 of Vlogmas. We have just under a week to go in vlogs every day and until the Christmas holiday. As we do get closer and closer to 2018, I find that I am cleaning out more closets, bookshelves, and figuring out what I need to keep and what I need to give away. So today's video are the top 10 things to get rid of before 2018. We are just under 2 weeks until the new year, so if you're looking for things to get rid of, then just keep watching. Number one, are clothes that you don't wear or clothes that just don't fit anymore. For all those clothes that you're holding on to and thinking, well, maybe one day I'll fit into these jeans or one day this dress will fit, do yourself a favor, give those away. If you want to keep one or two for maybe a little bit of like fitness inspiration the new year, that's okay. But if you have a full closet full of clothes and you're just saying, one day I'll wear them, do yourself a favor, pack them up, give them away, donate them, or sell them. Either way, just get rid of them. Number two are shoes that you have not worn all year long. Are there any pairs of shoes that you got last year on super sale during the Christmas and New Year season that have been sitting in your closet all year long, but you haven't found, you know, an occasion or a time to just wear them? Get rid of them. And once again, you can sell them or donate them. Either way, just get them out of your closet, out of your life. You don't even go here. Number three are magazines that you have been meaning to catch up on. Last year, I had my coffee table in my old apartment just covered with magazines in a stack, and I would keep them with the idea of, oh, on my day off, I'll just, you know, flip through them while I drink my coffee, but you know, on those days off, I would normally sleep in and then go out and meet my friends for coffee, and those magazines would just sit there and be unread. I do keep a few because my piano students' parents will come in and sit in my, like, living room while their kids take lessons and flip through them, but a majority of them need to go. Number four are extra sets of utensils, dishes, and silverware. If it's all just been sitting there unused this year, what do you think it's gonna do next year? For stuff like this, I don't like to resell it. I actually like to donate it to like the women's shelter or your city's homeless shelter. Those places could get a lot of use out of the things that just sit in your cupboard unused all year long. Number five is your 2017 paper planner. Not to be confused with your 2017 journal or diary, but take your planner, get all the important information off of it and transfer it into your 2018 planner, and then recycle that 2017 planner or agenda. Number six are any condiments that have been living in your fridge since the beginning of football season. Minus mustard, because I believe that never expires. Go through and see how your mayonnaise is doing, how your salad dressings are doing. If they need to go, toss those out. Last thing you want while ringing in the new year is a case of food poisoning. So clean that stuff out and bring in the new. Number seven are expired coupons. Grieve over the lost savings and move on. Number eight is one we're still working on over here, and it's the junk in your car. I practically live out of my car because I do so many things outside of my house, but at the end of the year, I like to go through there, clean it all out, throw the trash away, get things in here that need to be cleaned and stored away, and just start the new year fresh with a clean and vacuumed car. Number nine is jewelry that you don't use anymore. You can either re-gift it or resell it. Either way, just clean it out of your jewelry box and make space for anything new that might come into your life. And number 10 is everything in your junk drawers. Pour yourself some wine, set a 10-minute timer, and clean out all of your junk drawers. If it's something that you need, give it a designated home, and if it's something you don't need, pitch it and get rid of it. A book you might find helpful in this entire process is called The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up. I'll leave the information listed down below in the description box. It goes into great detail on how having a clean and organized home helps out with everything from like your stress levels, anxiety, to just knowing where everything is and knowing that you're only keeping the things that you like, use, and bring you joy on an everyday basis. That is my list of the top 10 things to get rid of before the year 2018. Leave me down below in the comments what you plan on getting rid of before we ring in the brand new year. If you like these kind of videos, make sure to let me know by giving this one a thumbs up. And if you have not done so already, click that little red subscription button down below. It'll update you each and every time I upload a new video. Thank you guys so much. Have a safe and happy holiday season and a great new year. I'll see you in tomorrow's Vlogmas video. Bye.
One more thing, you guys. This year, I have been nominated for a Broadway World Award for Best Leading Actress in a Musical from when I did Pirates of Penzance, and voting is open from now until December 31st. All you have to do to cast a vote is enter a valid email address. go down, click continue. I'll be category number 6, best leading actress in a musical. You can click continue through all of them. You'll find my name in category 6. And bonus points if you can find my boyfriend, Chris Rusin, he'll be in category 26. Once you click through all the categories, you'll enter your name, your email address. You'll select no to receive any future updates. Then you just click finish and you are done. Once again, voting is open from now until December 31st. Please share this with anybody who you would know would like to support the arts, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.